way back when that machine won.
Here for me. With Richie and Lenny and Ralphie and Ray and Al and Art and Walter. Is that how many? Six or seven? Huh? Oh. Oh, I'm sorry. And Skinny Huey. That's it there. Did you hear what happened? He walked into the pool room last night and three guys racked him. Chalked him right up on top of the head. Boy, are you skinny, boy. Oh, boy. Yeah. We had a big, tough time. They were having a convention of archers here today, and we had to fight this. One guy had him right there in the bow and pulled him right back, had feathers sticking out of him. Oh, I got a crew. Hey, now let's go to the words of wisdom. They're very important. Let's see Ginger Rogers do that. Let's see Roy Rogers do that. Okay, they're very important there. We want you to pay close attention to them. And they go like this. Show me an English policeman risking his life, and I'll show you a Bobby Darin. Boom. Now, just what do we mean by that?
Yeah. What do we mean by that?
Oh, hello there, Hobart.
Hiya, kid.
How are you?
Oh, I can't kick.
Yeah?
Rheumatism.
Kenny Youngman, 1922. Yeah.
Hey, you know, I'm pretty happy, though.
Yeah, what are you happy about?
Well, I'm happy because my son is a big baseball star.
Your son?
Yeah, he's with the Hot Stove League.
How's he doing?
Well, the coach is raking him over the coals now.
Yeah. Keep talking.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Tell me, so how long has he been the baseball player?
Oh, about a year now.
Yeah?
You know, yeah, he's a minor, you know.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, that's why he can't get in the big leagues. He's a minor, you
is that
know?
Why they're raking him over the coals?
Yeah.
I just threw that in.
Yeah, well, throw him right out.
Yeah.
Hey, but you know,
yeah?
You know, he learned a lot about baseball, not from me, you know.
Well, who did he learn baseball from?
Well, his greatest inspiration was Reba.
Your wife, Reba?
Yeah.
Well, what about her that inspired him for baseball?
Well, she had a lot to do with it, see?
Yeah?
Because she's got baseball eyes.
She's got baseball eyes?
Yeah, two baggers.
Yeah, that's...
But you know what, kid?
What?
Well, I hope he makes good.
Yeah.
You know, those baseball players, they make good, they get very wealthy.
Yeah.
Take Willie Mays, for example.
Yeah.
Mays is in oil.
Yeah.
Mickey Mantle's in oil.
Yeah.
Ted Williams is in oil.
Uh-huh. Well, what about your son?
He's in hot water. Yeah, they call him for stealing a base.
Well, you can't, there's nothing against law, baseball players stealing a base.
Fort Knox?
Oh. Oh, there's Reba.
Yeah, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Both of you stay still.
Come out, Hobart. Yeah, well, where are you, going in or coming out? Okay. Yeah, what are you, stand still.
Stay still.
Yeah.
Now, will the real dummy please stand up?
Listen, I... Foolishness. Don't get too close to the set. He's got a cold. You might catch it, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Look, Gib, look at it.
There he is.
Hiya, gang.
Can you...
Hey, they're awake.
Don't bet on it.
Okay.
Yes. Can you hate a long-haired lion?
Yeah.
Yes. No, you can't, because you're both. Attention. All right. Right face. Left face. Funny face. Oh, good. Does everything I tell. There you go, Eddie. Okay. Yep.
Oh, boy.
Yes.
Oh, nice being here today, you know?
Yeah. It's like being any place today, I can tell you that. Like that. Yeah.
Yeah, this place is really swinging today.
Yeah.
Or is it you that's swinging
today?
No,
it's not me.
Boy.
What's new?
Well, nothing much.
Yeah?
Yeah, no, I thought I'd come around because I wanted to, you know...
Come on in.
What?
Come on in.
You want to come in?
Yeah, come on in.
Oh, hey, yeah, maybe...
Oh, come on in. Can't keep them lions outside anymore. They're inside, and I think...
Hey, Bobby, this is a big place.
Will you quit running around there like a nut and come on over here? Come on over here.
I took a shortcut through the kitchen. I got lost in the refrigerator.
Yes. And you had a piece of cheese, didn't you? Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah?
Are they coming at us out there? What?
Just keep moving. Moving target's hard to hit. That's it. All right. Listen, what... All right, settle down. Settle down. See, I let you come into the house, you go crazy.
All right.
All right. Okay.
Oh, Boomy.
Yes?
Hey, How about a story?
Okay.
All right.
Did you bring in the book?
Yeah.
All right.
You want the book?
Yeah. Fairy tale?
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you. If you're young at heart.
Ooh, and if your liver's not too old, and the onions are right, and the celery is in season.
Let's see, why don't you tell a story, okay?
Okay, Booby.
Which one you want to tell?
Oh, you take your choice. I know them all.
Yeah.
My repertoire is vast.
Yeah? Well, how about Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs?
Nah, I don't think you like that one.
No. How about Cinderella?
You like that one?
How about the Shoemaker and the Elf?
Exactly what I was thinking, Booby.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You want to read it?
Yeah. Wait a few moments to check out a few details here.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
You know your nose is peeling? Your eyes
are... Wait, how many bars are trying to fake it? Oh, boy, you thought that woman's going to get by.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm all checked up.
Okay.
Once upon a time, a poor shoemaker lived with his wife in a brittle cottage, a little cottage. They had no brood, food to eat, and no money. And finally, the day came when the shoemaker had crusty bluff, just enough leather to make one pair of shoes.
Yeah.
Pat Fright, that night before he sent the said, went
he
to
went
bed.
He went to bed.
He carefully cut out the shoes so that not a flap of heather, a snap of weather, of leather was left. In the morning, the shoemaker awoke, and to his surprise, the moves were finished. The shoes were finished. The next morning after that, two pairs of shoes were finished.
Yeah.
And the next morning after that, three pairs of shoes were finished.
Yeah.
That evening, the shoemaker and his wife waited to see who the kindly visitors were that were finishing his shoes. For him during the blight. The spite work. During the night.
Yes, right.
On the stroke of midnight, through the window hopped two tiny men. The tragic people. The magic people. The elves.
Yeah.
They were wonderful little people,
yeah.
But they had no clothes on.
Yeah.
They finished the shoes that were there and left. Let us snow our little friends, grow our spittle brand, show our little friends we are grateful
right
for their
here.
Help. Let us stake them some nose, make them some clothes, said the shoemaker to his wife. So she cut tiny pants out of red velvet,
yes.
Little crackets, jackets out of blue silk. And tiny bats and tapes, cats and grapes, hats and capes out of white satin.
Yes.
That midnight, the elves climbed in through the window, saw the clothes, dressed themselves with much singing and dancing, and then hopped out the window, and the shoemaker and his wife smelt real good.
They smelt real good.
They had returned a flavor. No. Returned a flavor. And they lived happily ever after.
Now, see?
Wasn't that beautiful, Billy?
Yes.
Oh,
we must
hook me up.
Put some English subtitles along here so you can see what you said. Well, you've done it again.
Thank you, Booby.
what are you going to do tonight?
Well, we're going to do, something very unusual. Freddie and the gang and I. Yes, we're going
to... What are you and Freddie up to?
We're going to play a new game. We're going to have a pillow fight.
You see, that's the youth of today. They think something like that is new and vilified.
So you kids.
Remember, just yesterday we had one.
What's so unusual about a pillow fight? With a pillow filled with nails?
Well. Well, don't
to my lion. You have no permission to talk to him. When I want him up here, I'll talk to him. Because you don't understand him. It's all over town, man. Popo's calling you.
Oh, hi. Hi, Popo. How are you? Well,
there he goes. There he goes running right there.
Wow, he's fast.
Well, I tell you.
What's your problem, Booby?
Well, there's no particular problem.
Well, you look kind of sad. I was wondering.
Well, I've been watching the show up till now. No, it isn't that really.
What is it, Booby?
Well, I just hate to wash my linen in public. So we'll close the doors, you know. But there is a particular problem.
What's your problem?
Yes, I had this problem. And it's about this girl that moved in down the street.
Oh, yeah?
Pearl.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, what's
wrong? Hey, hey.
You took Bessie and Bertha? Yeah,
they let in a
they were elephants.
What do you mean they didn't know they were elephants?
Well, Betsy wore a mustache and Bertha wore a tuxedo.
That's the silliest thing I ever heard.
Did you like that tuxedo?
Now listen, hold it, Betsy, and you know, Bertha. Wait a minute here. How do you like it?
Betsy, how do you like it?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Now, I find that with a tuxedo and one of them wore a
right.
Mustache. I find that story hard to believe.
Well, give it all you got because it's the best I can do. It's the best we can do. Is that right, Betsy? Is that right, Bertha?
All right, you don't have to ask him every time you... All right. Listen, you tell me these things and you expect me to believe them, Herbie? What kind of an idiot do you think I am?
I don't know. Are there other kinds?
You hear that? You see what he's talking about?
Are there other kinds?
Don't ask her. What does she know? She's an elephant. Now, wait a minute. Now, just a second. Listen, who else was at the convention?
Oh, there were a lot of important people at the convention. You know who was there? The Beatles. Boy, Soup, I'll tell you.
The Beatles were there?
Yes. You know, they're good. You know what happened? They sang Old Man River, and 800 people did a swan dive off the balcony.
They dove off the balcony?
Yeah. Did they dive off the balcony?
You gotta ask them.
Did they dive? Even first? Yeah. And
you're gonna get in the ivories, Bessie. I can tell you that right now.
Get in the ivories. How about you, Bertha?
All right, wait a minute. You want to hear something funnier than that?
Yeah.
When they dove off, they were wearing bathing suits.
I hope so.
You want to hear something funnier than that?
What's that?
Ringo was wearing an aqualung.
What do you mean, Ringo?
What's Ringo wearing?
Don't ask her. What does she know?
Because they like to go swimming in aqualung, too. And they noticed that Ringo was wearing an aqualung.
And you want to hear something funnier than that?
What's that?
Johnny Weissmuller and Buster Crabb were ushers. Isn't that right, Bessie? Isn't that right, Bertha?
That's right. And they waited.
Yeah.
And you want to hear something funnier than that?
What's that?
Flipper is a better swimmer than Lloyd Bridges.
What does that have to do with
Bessie and Bertha at the convention?
Because they know how to swim. I just think better swimmer. Right? Flipper's a better swimmer.
Bessie, you're going to get it? Right in your big earlobes.
You're going to get it.
Oh, yeah. Take him down to the railroad station and get that trunk checked.
Now,
get
in there.
Just a minute. Oh, wait a minute.
What's that?
Hey, you know something, Soupy? You better get off those wet clothes or you're going to catch your death of cold.
That's right. Say goodbye, Bessie. He's got to go in and
change.
Say goodbye, Bertha.
Goodbye,
Bertha. He's got to go and change. And take care of yourself, too. Really? Yeah. I'll see you. Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Come on, Bessie. Heel there. Come on, Bertha. That's a good guy. Let's go.
You know what? Those elephants been to a circus because I smell peanuts on their breath.
We gotta go. Thanks for being with us. Have a great evening and wonderful day tomorrow. Good night, everybody.
Ralphie boy, what do you say we tell the folks out there in YouTube land all about Wayback Machine 1?
Everybody already knows that Wayback Machine 1 is the greatest, Naughton. Even the guys down at the bus station love it. If you're not already subscribed, you're nuts. So do it now, and away we go.
Wayback Machine 1.